Endocrine Surgery, caring for yourself after surgery. In this video, you will know how to take care of yourself after your endocrine surgery. This includes what to eat after surgery, how to prevent infection, what you should know about your calcium intake, thyroid supplements, and follow-up appointments. What to eat after surgery. Your throat may feel sore after surgery, but you will be able to eat a regular diet. You may have nausea the night of your surgery. Eat a light meal and drink fluids to help with the nausea. Prevent infections. Do not take a bath or go swimming for 2 weeks after your surgery. You can shower the day after surgery, but keep the water facing the back of your head. If the water goes on the front of your neck over the area where your surgery was, please dab the area dry. Steri-strip band-aids will be placed over your wound after surgery. Your surgeon may also use glue to close your wound. These are water-resistant and will keep water out of your wound.
The Steri-strips or skin glue will fall off after about 2 weeks.
When you go outside, you do not need to cover your wound since the sun cannot go through the Steri-strips or the glue. After the Steri-strips come off, your wound may look slightly red or swollen. This is called the healing ridge. This is normal and may take up to a few months to fully heal. You can help the healing process by gently massaging the area with vitamin E oil every day or using silicone strips. You can buy these from the drugstore. Talk to your doctor about caring for the healing ridge. Use sunscreen when you go outside to protect your wound from color change. This should be done for at least the first year after surgery. Ease into your regular activities over the first few days after leaving the hospital. Depending how you feel, you may resume other activities like going to the gym. Please talk to your doctor before you start lifting heavy weights. You will be able to drive once you are no longer taking narcotic pain medication and you are able to move your neck with ease. This may take up to 3 to 5 days after surgery. Know about your calcium intake. Some patients must take calcium after surgery. If your parathyroid glands are damaged or removed, your calcium levels may drop. If this happens, you may need to take calcium supplements for a few weeks after surgery. If you need calcium supplements, it will be prescribed to you by your surgeon. You may also be prescribed special vitamin D or calcitriol, which helps absorb the calcium. Note, it is important to take the dose of calcium that your surgeon prescribes.
4 out of every 100 patients having thyroid surgery may need calcium supplements long-term, potentially permanently. Calcium supplements are only needed if your whole thyroid has been removed. This is because the 4 parathyroid glands are at risk when you do operations on both sides of the neck.
If you develop any signs or symptoms of low calcium levels, you may need to take extra calcium. Symptoms of low calcium include numbness or tingling in the fingers or around the mouth or toes. If you have ongoing symptoms after taking the calcium supplements, please talk to your doctor or nurse. Thyroid supplements. Your thyroid levels are known as thyroid-stimulating hormone, also called TSH. If your TSH level is high, you will need to take a thyroid supplement. If only half your thyroid was removed, your surgeon will check your thyroid levels at your follow-up appointment. If your TSH levels are high, you may need to take a thyroid supplement. If your entire thyroid was removed, or you were already taking a thyroid supplement before your thyroid surgery, your surgeon will give you a prescription for a thyroid supplement before you leave the hospital. Thyroid supplements should be taken on an empty stomach. Do not take thyroid supplements with calcium. They do not work well when taken together. Many people wonder if their weight will change when they take a thyroid supplement. The thyroid hormone supplement that you may need is the same one as your body makes. If your thyroid level is normal, with or without a supplement, you should not have any weight changes related to the thyroid level. Talk to your surgeon if you have questions about thyroid levels. Follow-up appointments. You will see your surgeon 3 to 5 weeks after your surgery. During this appointment, your surgeon will review the pathology results with you and check how you are healing. You can check your pathology results on the MyUHN patient portal. MyUHN is a secure website for UHN patients to see their appointments and test results. Keep in mind that if you do check your patient portal, you will have to wait until you see your doctor in order to discuss the results with them. To register for MyUHN, go to www.myuhn.ca. Your surgeon will give you a long-term follow-up plan. This may include appointments with your surgeon and potentially seeing other specialists. This will depend on the results of your pathology report. If you have questions about your follow-up plan, talk to your surgical team. You've come to the end of this video on how to care for yourself after surgery. This included what to eat after surgery, how to prevent infection, what you should know about your calcium intake, thyroid supplements, and follow-up appointments.